Hello guys and welcome back. So in today's new episode, we need to install this toilet back wall. We have all the fittings here. We just need to put everything together and push it back to the wall. So I'm going to start to install the system. So my main water supply is going to be on my left side, and this is just going to come on the left side. And you can see you have the holes right here, and you can choose which side you are going to put it. Okay, so first I'm going to apply a little bit of silicone before installing. And we are just going to insert it in. And close it down. Okay, make sure that it's tightened up and out from the walls, not to touch the walls of the system, because it might block the system. Okay, so now same, I'm going to apply a little bit of sealant, and I'm just going to install it. Okay, so that is on. Don't forget these plastic washers. Don't tighten it too much because you don't want to break anything. Now this is our last thing, and we just need to cover the other hole here. If not, water is going to drip everywhere. So same thing, a little bit of silicone. Insert it in, first the plastic washer, and then we close it down. Okay, so for our last thing to do, okay, we just need to insert the overflow inside, just in case. Okay, so our last thing to do here, we just need to insert the overflow tube inside here. And that is, and I think that's it for our cistern. Now, before going forward, I'm just going to put my tank connector. It is a flexible one, which I think it's a lot easier because to work with, which I think it's a lot easier to work with because there is a long way to go in between the pipe and the actual connection to the toilet. Now you can even use an offset. In some cases you might need to use one of these, but the connection has to be quite close. You cannot have any space in between because you might get a leak. So that's why I always prefer for this type of toilet to use one of these, and then you can easily connect one with another and you can see while you are pressing it in. Now I already put a little bit of grease on the pipe, on the waste pipe, and I use some of this Hilti grease. I'm going to put a little bit even here. That is going to make it a little bit easier to slide, because it's quite a headache when you try to insert it in. Okay, before going forward, I'm just going to put it in. And that's done. Now, I want to put everything together before I'm going to put the cistern up. Just because I want to make sure that everything is going to go okay and I'm not going to have any headaches. Once that I'm going to put the cistern up, it's going to be a little bit heavier and a lot harder to work with. And that goes nice and tight. And I think everything is going to be fine. I'm just going to put it close to the wall. And that is going to be just fine. Now I just have to put my cistern on and the toilet is going to be ready. So before we are going to take it off, I'm just going to mark my holes here because I will have to drill into the floor so I can put the brackets that are going to hold the toilet, and the brackets are going to come in the pack. And are going to sit like that. So here we are going to put them onto the floor, drill, and then through this hole here. We are going just to insert the screw that is coming in a box, and it's going to go like that. So all these are going to come with the toilet, and then we can cut it off just like that. And it's not going to look bad when the job is going to be finished. So I'm going to quickly mark the holes. now we are going to put our cistern on. So back to our cistern. We have in the back this rubber that is going to go here, and then the bolts that are going to go from inside and through these holes here. So these are going to be inside the cistern like that, and that is going to hold the cistern together with the toilet. So I'm just going to put it on top now. So again, before I'm going to put the bolts in, I'm going to apply more silicone on them. And insert them in. Just like that. And then first is going to go the plastic washer and then the nut. Okay, so because that big rubber that I put it exactly in the middle, you are going to get this space here. So that means we need to tighten it till this space here is going to disappear. So now we just need to tighten it up. We can tighten it up even from above. And I think that is going to be enough. Yeah, at this point I'm just going to wipe out all the extra silicone and insert it in. We still have to connect the main supply of water, which is going to go right about here. Okay, so I have taken the toilet out again, because I wanted for you to see the toilet upside down, how it's going to be, all the connections. This is the main supply of water that I connected it. So at the back, everything is going to be exactly like this. The connection, you can put it straight in, so the connection, the main water connection, you can even put it before on the cistern, and just after that, if it's going to be long enough, you are going to connect it to the main supply. And yeah, depending how it's going to be better for you, in some cases it's going to be very difficult, and it's going to be easier to connect first the flexible that is going to go to the main. So this is how it's going to look from the back. I was trying to film while I was putting everything, but it was too dark, and I don't think you would have seen all the details that are going to go there at the back. So at this moment, I'm just going to quickly put it back. I'm quickly going to put the toilet seat on. Okay, so now I'm going to prepare the flush for the flush on top of the cover, which is going to be easy to install. You have some adjustments here. Sometimes it's not going to reach on top of the flush valve, and these, they will have to go a little bit longer. So all that adjustment is from here. Okay. We also are going to have some covers that are going to go right around here. That's one, and we have another one on the other side. And I'm going to insert that in a moment if I can find it, because it's quite a mess around here. Okay, so I found it, and it's going to go on the other side. That is going to make it look nice. Now, I'm just going to turn the main supply and check, see if I'm going to get any leaks. And then I'm just going to put it all the way back to the wall. Now, I always going to recommend to leave it a little bit before you are going to go back to the wall, because on this type of toilets, you cannot see what is going to happen at the back. So if you are going to seal it all around with silicone and even at the bottom, the bad thing about these type of toilets is that you are never going to see the leak. And because you are going to seal everything, the water is just going to stay inside here and it's never going to come outside, and you are never going to know that you have a leak till it's going to be too late, of course, and everything is going to go in the room downstairs, if you are on the first floor, of course. And by then, all your joists and ply and whatever you have as a subfloor here is going to be badly damaged. So that is the bad thing about these toilets. You can never know if you are going to get a leak, if you have already a leak, and it's going to be quite late. Alright, so right now I'm going to put my water supply on. And it started to fill. Right now I'm going to do a couple of flushes, and then I'm just going to leave it for 10-20 minutes, and I'm going to block it with the screws that are supplied in the box, the screws that are going to be at the bottom of the toilet. These ones. Nothing is coming out, and that is good.
All right. Okay.
And everything, it seems that it's working fine. No problems, no leaks. Now the toilet can go back to the wall and be fixed to the floor. So I tidy it up a little bit around here. I had a small break and everything is nice and dry, and now we can put the toilet back. Okay, so our video just came to an end. I really hope that this small guide is going to help you in some way. And of course, at this point, don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you on the next one.